Good morning, everyone. So it is March 22nd, Friday. It is 9:30, and I am gonna go get me a little snack. Not really a little snack, a little treat. Let me say a little treat. So if you guys follow me on Instagram, you saw that I posted about an Instagram account called The Macro Barista. And basically it's an account where this guy who he makes macro friendly Starbucks drinks and now even just regular coffee drinks like at home. So yeah, I am going to choose what coffee I want and I'm going to go to Starbucks and order it. So I'm gonna go ahead and head to Starbucks. I'll show you guys what I end up getting. And if y'all don't know, I will link his Instagram below. Before I go, I also am going to be doing another full day of eating today, and it's gonna be, again, I don't know why I do these on my low carb days, but it is another low carb day today, which means I'm not working out today. It is my rest day. So I'm going to be making meals throughout the day. And yeah, if you guys want to see some macro-friendly ideas, or once again, how you keep track of your macros. I woke up this morning at 124.8. I update my coach in 2 days. Oh no, I update my coach tomorrow. So we'll see what he says. We'll see if there are any more changes. And if there are, I'll keep you guys updated. Guys, it is absolutely freaking beautiful outside. Like, there are no clouds in the sky. It's like so breezy. I don't know if y'all can see that. It is so breezy. It's just like, man, I am lucky. We are blessed. We are grateful to be alive. That's how you gotta think every morning. But no, seriously, it is beautiful outside. Like, I'm happy to be off today. Let's go to Starbucks. Okay guys, so I just got back from getting my coffee. I just wanted to let you guys know exactly what it is that I got. Again, if you guys are not following the Macro Barista, definitely go check him out. So what I got was the salted caramel mocha. The breakdown of this is 100 calories, 14 grams of carbs, 1 gram of protein, 3 grams of fat. So you are gonna be using some carbs in this. That's why I said I like to use it as a treat once a week. I would not do this every day just because I don't want to use my carbs on coffee. But it tells you exactly how to order as well right there. So order a grande cafe misto, add 1 pump of toffee nut, 1 pump of mocha, substitute with almond milk, and you can add 1 or 2 zero calorie sweeteners. So yeah, guys, I just got it. And holy cow, this is probably my favorite one so far. Really love it. It doesn't have that strong taste of coffee, because you know how sometimes you can get like mixed coffee drinks, but it still kind of tastes like straight coffee. This has definitely like a sweeter taste to it, which I love. And I got it warm, so I'm not sure if you can change it. I'm pretty sure you can change it to ice, but yeah, I just got it warm. So yeah, guys, the Macro Barista on Instagram, definitely give him a follow if you count or track your macros and you like coffee. Okay guys, first meal of the day. You guys can't really see me from there, but I'm going to start by scanning my items to make sure that they fit my carbs. So breakfast, I'm going to have an English muffin, and you guys know I love my Dave's Killer Bread, so I'm gonna have one of these because they do contain protein, which helps me get my protein in for the day. Just little things, guys, little things that you can add in here and there if you feel like you can't normally hit your protein or your carbs. Just few things to add in here and there always helps. So yeah, Dave's Killer Bread. I'm gonna go on my Fitness Pal and I'm going to scan it. But basically what you do with MyFitnessPal is you'll scan the barcode and it automatically, and I'll show you guys. So I'm gonna go to my diary. I'm gonna add breakfast, scan the barcode, 26 grams of carbs, 1.5 grams of fat, and 6 grams of protein. So what I'm gonna do for you guys is I'm gonna record it on here and then just pull my screen up on the screen so you guys can see exactly how I do it. So as you guys can see here, I'm just showing you how exactly I just scan the barcode of each item that I'm using, and the information pops right up at the top, all macros and everything. It breaks everything down for you. So if you do not use MyFitnessPal, definitely recommend them. They are very easy to use, very helpful when it comes to counting macros. So here I'm scanning the turkey now and the information pops up. And if you guys want to see the information for the full day so far, here I did not include my coffee yet, but I did at the end of the day. But so far with these three items, these are our macros. So yeah, guys, it's a very helpful tool if you don't have it yet. Okay, so guys, what I like to do first is heat up my turkey on the pan, on the stove. So turn that bad boy on, and usually we use a coconut oil one, but I guess they didn't have it, so we got this one. But you just spray a little bit of this, not too much. I just lay out the turkey on there so it heats up, gets nice and warm. We're gonna do 4 slices because that is the servings. So 4 slices. And we're only doing 4 slices because that's the serving that I put into MyFitnessPal. If I'm gonna add more, I gotta put it in MyFitnessPal. One egg. So guys, with the cheese, you definitely want to get fat-free so it doesn't add to your fats. At least I don't want it to add to my fats. So I get the fat-free cheese, and this is mozzarella. And you're going to make sure that you are doing exactly what the serving size or portion is, guys. So if you're going to add, make sure you add it to your macros. Or if you're gonna do less, make sure you take some out. But this is one serving size, is 28 grams or 1/4 cup. So what I'm gonna do here, so I'm gonna set my scale to the grams, which it already is. Make sure it's at 0. And we're gonna go up to 28 grams. So 25, 26, 27, 28. All right, so we are at 28 grams of, I don't know if you guys can see that, of cheese. And that's what you're gonna put on your sandwich. I decided to add a little more fat to my breakfast just because since it is my low carb day, I'm going to have higher fat today. So I added a little more fat to my breakfast. Of course, healthy fats. So I added some avocado. It was about 30 grams of avocado that I added. So that ends up being an additional 4.8 grams of fat, 3.2 grams of carbs, and 0.5 grams of protein. So I'm adding avocado to my sandwich, guys. Avocado is an amazing source of healthy fats. So if you like avocado, definitely take advantage. And what I'm gonna do is just gonna add just a little bit of pink Himalayan salt, which is the best kind of salt, guys. Keep that in mind, pink Himalayan. And then a little bit of black pepper. And there you have it, guys. A nice breakfast sandwich. Definitely hitting my goals for a breakfast meal
for my macros, and yeah, I'm ready to eat.
Okay guys, so it is a little past lunchtime. It is 4:08 and I haven't eaten since breakfast this morning. So I'm going to be making some zucchini pasta. If you guys have never made zucchini pasta, it is good, especially if you don't want to use carbs. So obviously pasta has a lot of carbs in it, but if you just use the zucchini pasta, which I got this at Sprouts and it comes just like this. It has zero fat, 10 calories, total carbs is 3 per serving, and 1 gram of protein. So yeah. So if you guys love your noodles, but don't wanna sacrifice the carbs, this is the way to go. So I'm gonna use some olive oil for the pan. Every serving is about 15 milliliters, so I'm just gonna weigh that out. Every 5 grams of garlic is 1 gram of carbs, so obviously I would want to do that as well and weigh this out. I just put the whole thing in there because the more it cooks, the more it's gonna shrink up. And you'll see that it's really not that much. So let that sizzle in there for a little bit. So there we have it, some zucchini, some sauce. We're gonna let that cook for just about, maybe about 5 to 6 minutes, and then I'll add salt and any other kind of condiments that I want to add to it. So this is the sauce that I use. I will let you guys know how I liked it. It's by Walden Farms. I use actual olive oil. I know I usually use grapeseed oil, but I use olive oil for this. I only use 1 serving of the olive oil. I used 2 servings of the garlic. And obviously put the whole thing in there. So I'll let you guys know how it comes out, and I'll keep you all updated on this right here. And guys, I am putting meat in there, but I'm not going to show you guys how to make it because it's already made. So I am gonna be putting some beef in there as well. So then it'll have a little bit more to it than just zucchini pasta. So I will be adding the beef, and I'll show you guys the measurements and macros of everything put together at the end. So guys, this is what it's coming out to look like. Looks so good, smells really good. Do here is about 5 ounces of protein, or my lean ground beef, because usually I do about 4, but I'm doing 5 because I'm kind of slacking on my protein so far today. Just been busy, and it happens. Never mind, I'm doing 4.3 ounces of beef, which I'm cool with still. Just gotta find a way to get my protein in. So I'm doing 4.3 ounces of lean ground beef. And yeah, I'll show you the finished product. Guys, little update. I failed to record the finished product because it looked way too good and I was starving. And I ate it. So I will go ahead and put the macros right here for this meal. And if you guys have any questions or anything on how to make it, just let me know. I tried to incorporate or to put in this video everything that I did. At the end, I did actually put some more or some mozzarella cheese, but the fat-free one. So I did put one serving of that in there as well, and it was really good, guys. So I definitely recommend for low carb days. If you want some spaghetti or craving it, just get zucchini pasta and kind of make it up as you go, because that was really good, guys. So yeah, again, if you have any questions, let me know, and I will see y'all in the next clip when I'm doing my next meal. Okay, guys, so because I was still a little hungry after the zucchini pasta, I went ahead and put some Cheerios. These are actually peanut butter Cheerios. It's 40 grams of Cheerios that I have here. So I went ahead and added that as well to my Fitness Pal, so then it could take from my macros. So yeah, this is just kind of like a little snack after my meal. What's up, guys? So it is currently much later at night. I just got back from hanging out with a few friends. We just went to dinner. Well, they went to dinner. I obviously could not eat, but I did enjoy the time out with them. I did fail to actually record my meal before I left. Basically what I had was half a cup of rice and three whole eggs, so that just added a little more carbs, fats, and protein. And now that I'm back, I still have some food that I have left to eat. So for protein, I'm gonna have a can of tuna fish, and then I'm going to have and then I'm going to have 33 grams of this. I love this stuff. I love this stuff, guys. If you guys have never tried Nuts and More, all their flavors are bomb AF. This one's really good. The chocolate one's really good. My favorite one is the cookie dough one. You guys can get this at Extreme Body Nutrition. Plug. And so I'm gonna have 33 grams of that. And then also yogurt. So I like these yogurts. It's Greek yogurt. That'd be your best option to get if you get yogurt. So it is Greek yogurt. It is a light and fit, and this is strawberry cheesecake. So this one's really good, and I'm gonna have this, and that will conclude my macros for the day. So I'm gonna go ahead and eat those three things, and yeah, that's my day. Every day, just counting them up, making it work, making them fit. I'm obnoxious when I eat these, because I can never eat everything that's on the spoon. I just slightly skim over the top. Anybody else do that? Is it just me? Hope everyone enjoyed their day. Hope this was helpful. And catch y'all on the flip side. Say bye.
Bye. 10 second hold. Right there. Up. Right there.
Oh, you're